In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon His last and beloved Messenger Muhammad, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all. This is the eighth part of a series entitled Discoveries from the Quran. And in this series, brothers and sisters, I show, with the guidance of Allah God Almighty, the superiority of knowledge of Allah in the last revelation to people the Quran over all the branches of knowledge of people in this day and age. Also, how a believer can be the teacher of others by pondering upon the verses of the Quran. So among the topics for this part is the topic you see on the screen, the similarity between Satan and computer viruses. Now, the matter of how Satan affects each and every one of us is something of great importance, and I wanted to clarify this more and more by giving an example from computer science and showing the similarity between the effect of Satan on our body and the effect of computer viruses on computers. Now, to begin with, Allah God Almighty in the Quran, in a single verse, explains to us how Satan affects each and every one of us. He explains to us the scientific method or scientific mechanism on how Satan affects each and every one of us. And it's the verse number 4 of chapter 114 of the Quran. This is translation. From the evil of the whisperer who hides. So Allah God Almighty is teaching us here that there is an evil, there is a harm from the effect of Satan. And Allah tells us that Satan is a whisperer. Whisperer meaning that the way Satan communicates with you is that he talks to you. Again, so the way Satan can affect you is that he talks to you, like a person talking to you. But at the same time, he hides from you, meaning he doesn't want you to feel his presence. So the question is, how can Satan affect each and every one of us by talking to us and at the same time we don't feel his presence? And from the Quran we learn as well that each and every one of us has a companion devil, meaning that every one of us has a devil assigned to him at birth and it stays with him till death. So no one is immune from this. So the only way that Satan can talk to you but at the same time you don't feel his presence is that if he matches his voice with regards to the languages you know, the tone, the style of your speech, to the voice you hear in your head. Each and every one of us, when we think quietly, we hear a voice exactly similar to the one we talk with, but in our head. So what Satan does, the companion devil of every person, he matches his voice, he makes his voice identical to the one you hear in your head. So you experience thoughts, they pop up in your mind, and you think that yourself is telling you this because the voice is identical, well, actually it's Satan. And he talks to you and you hear these thoughts in your mind, urging you to commit harm, to hurt yourself and others, to commit perverted sexual acts, sinful acts, and to blaspheme, urging you to insult Allah God Almighty, to insult Prophet Muhammad, to insult the Quran. That's the effect of Satan. And the reason you don't feel his presence because he matches his voice the one you think with. Now, having understood this, let's explain this further by giving the similarity between this effect and the effect of computer viruses on the computer. I'll give an example in each step, Allah God willing. So the first similarity is Satan entering human mind and computer viruses entering the CPU. So the way that a computer virus enters a computer undetected is that the designer of the virus makes it similar to the files found in the computer. For example, the computer, you have text files, you have audio files, you have video files. So the designer of the virus makes the virus similar to the files so it can enter the computer undetected. Similarly, Satan, the way he enters your system undetected is, as I said, he matches his voice with all aspects, tone, frequency, languages you know, to your own voice. So that's how he enters your system undetected. You don't feel his presence because the voice is similar to the one you hear in your mind. So you think that yourself is so clever, is telling you this, or why do I hear these kind of thoughts, blasphemy, lust, and harm? I hope now it's becoming clearer and clearer how the similarity between the two, in order to clarify how does Satan affect each and every one of us. Another point, the usage of memory by Satan and computer viruses. Now, another effect of computer viruses is that the virus uses the memory of the computer. How? That the virus keeps running itself, its program. And due to this continuous running, it occupies, it takes so much of the memory of the computer, the RAM. And as a result of this, the space left for useful programs has become less and less. And that's the reason, one of the reasons why when you have a virus in your computer, it becomes slower, because it takes so many resources of the computer, so the room for useful usage becomes less. Similarly, Satan occupies the memory of a person. How? Let me give you real examples. The mechanism is that he talks to you with a voice matched the one you think with. For example, you heard a song or a funny kind of clip. He keeps reminding you of this clip in your mind. He keeps singing the song in your mind. Why? Because he wants to occupy your memory. So when you hear something about the message of Allah to people, the Quran, you don't have enough memory in your mind to handle both. So he keeps putting information in your memory, useless information, reminding you of a funny clip, you see people laughing with no reason, keeping a song in your mind, reminding you of a conversation you had in the morning. If I said this, what would I have said? Like you are talking and somebody's answering you in your mind, and now you know who's answering you in your mind, Satan. Reminding you of a conversation you will have tomorrow, daydreaming, or this from Satan. And as I said, one of the aims of Satan in this, because you are preoccupied with all of this, you don't have enough room when you hear this lecture, for example, about the Quran, the message of Allah to people, what would benefit you in your life. So he wants to occupy with useless things, such that you would have pain and despair in this life and the hereafter. He wants to waste your life and waste your hereafter as well. Another point, overuse of CPU due to Satan and computer viruses. Now, in the computer, there's something called the CPU, the central processing unit. This is the brain of the computer. You have inputs, outputs, and logical actions are taken within the CPU. Now, what a computer virus does is that, as I said, he keeps running itself, putting inputs and outputs, overusing the CPU. As a result of this, there is an increase in the temperature of the computer, fatigue, disturbance in the performance of the computer. Likewise, Satan, he overuses your brain. Let me give you an example. Suppose that a person washes himself. When he's coming out of the washroom, a thought pops up in his mind from Satan, telling him with a voice match the one he thinks with, "You are unclean. You have diseases. Go and repeat the wash." So as a result, you overuse your brain. You keep washing and doing, running actions. And as a result of this, you experience increase in body heat, fatigue, and all of these problems. Another example. You are going to work in the morning. A thought pops up in your mind that, "I forgot to lock the front door. I'll be robbed. That will happen to me." You become agitated, increased by the temperature, fatigue. So you see the similarity between the two. And the aim of Satan in this, one of his aims, is to cause you pain and despair, to waste your life, to waste your potential, to cause you pain in any way, basically. Another point, wrong outputs due to Satan and computer viruses. Now, in the computer, for example, you click the mouse to print a page. If you have a virus on the computer, it can take that command and do something else. For example, shut down the computer or do something else. So wrong outputs. Similarly, what Satan does is the following. Allah in the Quran tells us, for example, about alcohol, that it's forbidden to drink alcohol. And Allah gives you reasons for that. Now what Satan does is that he comes to you with a voice match the one you think with, telling you, for example, that you had a rough day, You're so stressed out. So why don't you consume a little bit of alcohol just to relax, just to unwind? You're not hurting anybody. And all of this you hear in your mind by a voice much the one you think with. So Satan wants to give you wrong outputs. So Allah wants to give you correct outputs that will benefit you in this life and the hereafter. Satan wants to give you wrong outputs to destroy this machine, basically, the human body. So you see the similarity between the two? Okay, coming now to the cure. What's the cure for all of this? Now, the way we cure computer viruses, or we stop the effect of computer viruses, many ways, but basically there are two main ways to do this. The first way, to delete the computer virus, to delete the virus from the computer. And that is done, but sometimes there are viruses that are too kind of difficult to delete, or they're too strong. So what we do something called quarantine. We quarantine the virus, meaning it stays in the computer, but you stop the effect of this virus on the computer. That's quarantine. Now, with Satan, there is no way that you can delete Satan. There is no way that you can remove it from your system. This companion devil, with each and every person, will stay with you till death. There is no way you can delete it. What you do, you quarantine, meaning you reduce the effect of this, of Satan, on your life. How do you do that? From the Quran. No one can help you except Allah. No one can help you with this. Not the best psychiatric help, not psychology, not modern medicine. Nothing can help you except Allah by pondering upon the Quran. So in the Quran, in chapter 2, verse 168, Allah states, O people, eat of that which is lawful and good on the earth, and do not follow the footsteps of Satan. Verily, he is to you an open enemy. This is the how we can quarantine Satan. And do not follow the footsteps of Satan. Let me give you an example. Suppose he comes to you with a voice match the one you think with in your mind, telling you to drink alcohol. What you need to do, as Allah says, do not follow the footsteps of Satan. Do not agree nor carry out what he's telling you. Ignore these thoughts. That's the way you quarantine, you reduce the effect of Satan on your life. After you understand all of this, when he comes to you with a voice match the one you think with, containing harm, lust, and blasphemy, ideas containing harm, lust, and blasphemy, ignore these thoughts. Do not agree with them nor carry them out. And day after day, you reduce the effect of Satan on your life. That's how you quarantine the effect of Satan. I hope now it's clear, and Allah guided me to this example from computer science to make this topic more understandable. You understand it more, Allah God willing. And this, the topic of how Satan affects each and every one of us, is something of great importance, as I said. And it's a fact from the Quran that will change the world. Because so many people, they hurt each other, and they hurt Muslims, and they become addicts. All of this from the effect of Satan on us. So once a person realizes this truth from the Quran, and the cure from the Quran as well, the way I explained it, from the guidance of Allah, then this will change his life. It will bring him happiness in this life and the hereafter. And to know more details about this topic, please visit my website at www.quran-miracle.com. This is the website, and you can email me at zquran@gmail.com. And may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all.